Happy Thanksgiving, everyone, from everyone here at 2K Sports. Nothing like the NBA for Turkey Day. With Greg Anthony and Hall of Famer Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan. And we're pleased to have on the sidelines tonight, David Aldridge. DA, it's all yours.
Well, Kevin, some people questioned the contract that Terry Rozier got from the Hornets in 2019. But 3 years later, he earned an even bigger deal. He says, "I work my tail off because that's all I know. The money will be there. I'm more excited that I can just show my talent every night, what I'm about, and who Terry Rozier really is." Kevin, back to you.
Love the motor. DA, thanks. A lot of focus on the guard matchup tonight, Greg. Both these teams rely on their backcourts to lead the way for them.
And if anything, it should make for an entertaining basketball game. And it becomes a little bit of a chess match when it's a backcourt duel. Those are always fun.
And checking out Minnesota's opening lineup. Two big men inside, Towns and Gobert. Sliding in at the wing, it'll be Edwards and McDaniels. And it's Russell in at the one spot. And for Charlotte, the big men on the floor. It's Washington and Plumlee. Rozier on the wing along with Hayward. And it's Ball in at the point guard. And it's Rozier missing. McDaniels with the ball. Pass to Gobert. Now here's McDaniels. Gobert with a screen on Rozier. Five to shoot. Stolen by Ball. The pass to Hayward. Back to Ball. Pass to Washington. Here's Ball. With an average of around 19 and a half points a game, his scoring has been a constant for them. Plumlee, Gobert with the block. And they turn over the 24-second buzzer, signaling the shot clock violation. A sensational block that definitely deserves another look.
And right out of the gate, trying to set the tone defensively, you gotta love that energy.
Here's Minnesota. And this is the first time matched up with the Hornets this season.
And both of these sides were fighting tooth and nail for a playoff spot and split their season series at one apiece.
Now here's Edwards. His last outing, we saw him pour in 22. Towns sets the pick for Edwards. And off there, he misses his first shot of the night.
There's one thing that's become clear about this Hornets team. They've become one of the best passing teams in the league.
Hayward passes the ball. Now Rozier from the arc. And Karl Anthony Towns pulls it down. Little over a minute 30 into this first quarter. Here's Russell. And he drops in the layup off the glass. And Charlotte's passing has improved a lot in the last few seasons. Greg, even more.
Yeah, their assist numbers have been terrific. And they keep their turnovers to a minimum. That's a trend you want to see continue.
Charlotte has gone 0 of 2 from deep here. Rozier against Edwards. And Plumlee kicks the ball. Off to a good start as he hits his first shot attempt.
What a finish by LaMelo Ball. Thin frame, but that length at 6'7", he can mix it up now.
Edwards dishes to Gobert. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
And there's a record Rudy Gobert set without much fanfare a few years ago. Most dunks in an NBA season.
That's exactly right, GA. That was back in the 2018-19 season. He threw it down 306 times. Certainly makes sense for a guy who's got that kind of length, athleticism, and the guy who spends so much time right around the cup.
He misses the free throw.
And one of the biggest stories of the summer was Rudy Gobert being traded. Gets a fresh start with the Timberwolves.
And he's good on the second.
And last year, Minnesota had a tough end to their season. In their 10th playoff appearance, they made their 9th first-round exit.
Plumlee sets the pick for Ball. Now Plumlee. 9-point game, his last outing. The kick out to Rozier. No luck that time in the shot that would have put them on top. I don't think the Timberwolves, Greg, plan on letting their playoff statistics discourage them at all.
And that's kind of the beauty of this squad. They're out to make new franchise history, not focusing on the past. Just keep evolving as a team.
Now, here's Ball. With an average of around 19.5 points a game, his scoring has been a constant for them. Rozier with a screen on Gobert. Here's Ball. Knocks it down from 7 feet.
Well, the great length and the great size of the backcourt, LaMelo Ball continues to improve as an interior scorer.
Passes it to Edwards. And Gobert kicks to Edwards. And the layup's good off the glass.
Just setting the tone with an aggressive move to the rack. And where's the help defensively?
To me, that's a complete lack of communication on that side of the ball. These guys need to be talking to each other.
For Charlotte, they've gone 2-6 from the field. Ball against Russell. Takes the three. And it's LaMelo Ball with the three. Ball's got 7.
This guy is always ready to shoot the three. LaMelo's so confident from distance.
Outside, Edwards. Lets it go with the three. And they recover it. Lets the three fly. Kept alive. And Gobert throws it down.
That's so long, so athletic. Rudy Gobert with a big-time dunk.
And that last look brought to you by the AT&T 5G Slam Cam. We've got 1:08 left in the first quarter. So Charlotte calls timeout. They're first. Defeated by the Wizards in their last game, they'll try to put that one behind them.
And missing your free throws usually changes the complexion of a game. Certainly did in that one.
You know this. Nothing gets a crowd into the game more than a bunch of missed free throws. That's one of the worst things you can do on the road.
So an almost entirely new group in now for Charlotte. Nick Richards, he's checked in for Plumlee. McDaniels comes in for Gordon Hayward. Oubre's checked in for Rozier. And Smith's subbed in for Ball. .105 left here in the opening quarter. Here's Richards, guarded by Reed. Richards passes to Smith to the right side. Smith on the wing, just 5 to shoot. Stolen by Reed. Here's Noel, covered by Oubre. Kicks it to Anderson. Pass to Reed. One up, one down, 2 points with his first shot this game.
Taking back the lead once more. Give these teams credit. Man, they are battling.
Neither team willing to give an inch, and neither able to seize the momentum. This has been a fascinating one to watch.
And that's out of bounds. Charlotte will retain possession. .19 seconds left in the first. Inside, stolen by Reed. And here is Prince. A look at his stats. He averages a bit over 8 points a game. For three, Forbes. A good close contest so far as we finish the first quarter. Timberwolves ahead. They're up by two. And the second quarter will be on the way when we come back. Thanks for joining us in this Thanksgiving presentation of the NBA. And guys, what's your take so far on the Timberwolves?
Playing inside out in that first quarter led to some high percentage shots in the paint.
It is great when you can get that established early, because to me it opens up every other aspect of your game.
Minnesota in the lead. During last offseason, the Hornets decided to part ways with their coach of the past 4 years.
Always a tough decision, and this is a critical time for Charlotte. They've got a tremendous young core. They think their time is now, and they want to make a bold move with the new hire.
And so in the game for the Timberwolves, Trent's out there with Anderson. Then there's Reed, and it's Forbes in at the point. Here's Richards. The pass to Booknight. Off target with his three.
I'm shocked that didn't turn into 3 points. I mean, he makes you pay on those nearly every time.
Pass to Noel. And it's blocked. Prince against Oubre. Here's Booknight. No good on the triple. Timberwolves leading by four. Anderson outside. It's taken away by Smith. And a fast break now for the Hornets. Smith's running. And Smith with the stuff.
Yeah, this guy is a nightmare in transition for the defense. Dennis Smith Jr. in space. Look out.
So the Timberwolves called their first timeout, evaluating recent attempts, Doris, to create super teams. They haven't quite worked out as planned, have they?
What we understand now is the game isn't played on paper. So many things go into winning: chemistry, health. And if you risk your future trying to put together a super team with no consideration for what comes next, that can be problematic.
So a whole new group on the floor now for Charlotte. And we're a little over a minute and a half into the second quarter of action. To the paint. Fades away. First shot, first basket. He's out of the blocks fast.
In the modern NBA, the three-level score is so hard to deal with. Karl-Anthony Towns in the mid-range, that's money.
And let's head over to the sideline and catch up with David Aldridge.
Thanks very much. Now, you may not know this, but Gordon Hayward was a two-time Indiana State singles champion in tennis. He says, in high school, I was better at tennis than basketball, but I've always loved hoops more. Thankfully, I was able to grow throughout high school to get to the frame I have now. He has certainly filled out in the NBA. Kevin, back to you.
Yeah, he sure has. He's been a terrific player to watch and follow. The injury is significant, but he continues on. David, thanks. Now, here's Ball. Anthony Edwards unable to get his last shot to go in. Rocket two over Russell. Ball no good.
I think this is a spot he has got to become more consistent from if you want to command the defender's respect.
So many electric players in this NBA, Doris. But do you think LaMelo Ball is as exciting as any?
He is at the top of the list, but that list is long. Think about a Ja Morant. Think about an Anthony Edwards. The league is in good hands for decades to come.
Yeah. Hornets trail by four. Now, here's Ball. 7 points in the game. Over Russell. Ball, no good. And here's Edwards. He'll bring it up for the Minnesota Timberwolves. Their defense has only allowed 4 points in the quarter. Scores for only the second time tonight. Now 2 for 6 from the field.
They've settled into a nice groove offensively here in the second.
Ball, the pass to Plumlee. And it's slammed in by Plumlee.
If you leave a teammate of LaMelo Ball that wide open, I promise you he will find him.
Timberwolves leading by four. Edwards finds Russell. Gobert with a screen on Ball. Russell passes to Gobert. Nice ball movement by Minnesota. Drains it from beyond the arc. Edwards got the lead up to 7 now for Minnesota.
Well, don't think twice. Ball touches your hands, you let it go, Anthony Edwards.
And the basket by Rozier. Rozier's got his first bucket of the night.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. That's on Terry Rozier.
Well, Anthony Edwards has the kind of frame and skill set that can make him a force, but it all comes down to paying the price and putting in the work now.
And he makes the first. And you look at Anthony Edwards, and G.A., he is becoming the leader of this Timberwolves team, isn't he?
I think he is. I mean, partly it's his production with his numbers up across the board, but it's also his personality. He plays with tremendous swagger.
Nick Richards, he's checked in for Mason Plumlee, and Edwards drops them both.
And how about the impact Anthony Edwards has had?
This guy's a real game changer on the floor. Scores it at a high clip, can play big inside and play big outside, does everything on the floor with a passion, with a joy, and with a flair.
Yeah, just a solid job on the backboard. They are really controlling the inside.
Russell, no good. Hornets trail by 7. Washington kicks to Rozier. Passes to Richards. To the inside.
Oh, the officials are all over that one.
First trip to the free throw line for him in this one.
Shooting two.
That free throw, no good. The Timberwolves secured a spot in the playoffs last season, Greg, and we enjoyed it. After they got that emotional win in the play-in game in the Twin Cities over the Clippers. What a night.
And Kevin, you could tell it meant a lot to the players. This is a team that has struggled for so long, and by getting to the playoffs, this is a step in the right direction.
So we can't get either to fall. You know, Hornets fans, Doris, are excited to see what LaMelo Ball can do for the franchise.
Well, Kevin, there is no doubt this young man is a special talent. You look no farther than his passing ability, the flair, the vision, the fearlessness. Certainly an easy guy to play with. Now the question becomes, can you start to build the talented pieces around him?
And they've repeatedly probed inside in the first half, guys, and it's paid off.
Now here's Booknight. D right on him. Bucket is good.
Well, what a job. Punching the ball to the interior and finishing in the paint. Nice.
Here's Noel. And no good on the last second attempt this time. And that concludes the first half. Timberwolves lead by 7. And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thank you, Kevin. Carl, you guys have built a lead. What is the key to maintaining or increasing it going forward?
I mean, don't change what we're doing. Just stay together, keep passing the ball, keep playing great defense, and just keep making them think and make decisions, especially the difficult ones.
You had the advantage in the first half. We'll see if you can keep that advantage in the second half. Thanks for your time, man. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. And we'll be back after halftime as the third quarter gets underway.
Thanks for stopping by, y'all. First up on the show tonight, a quick look ahead of some upcoming games on the docket. Some exciting games in store for us. Check. Rate your level of excitement on a scale from 1 to 1,000,000.
I'm going to go with 900,000, 800,000, 750,000.
Final answer? Okay. Incorrect.
Well, I'm glad you didn't ask me.
Now back to our game. Pretty impressive first half for the Timberwolves.
Listen, right now their offense reminds me of a big old great buffet with balance running smoothly, and they're serving a barbecue chicken and macaroni and cheese and cornbread and coleslaw and a diet soda.
And I'm sure you'll be looking for some dessert in the second half, big fella.
Ooh, some banana pudding would hit the spot right now.
Oh, you're telling me. Ooh, hot
apple pie. I like me some good banana pudding.
Ooh, hot apple pie for me.
Oh, yeah, I like that, too. Ooh, a little peach cobbler.
Ooh, stop it.
Yeah, I like that, too.
And don't forget that brownie with that ice cream and that hot fudge and that, ooh, and that cheesecake. Oh, man.
Thanks for spending halftime with us. Time to get it back out to Kevin Harlan for the start of the third quarter.
And happy you could join us. We've got two quarters left to go in regulation. You have to like what we're seeing from Anthony Edwards.
And you know he's going to put up points every time out, but boy, he made it look so easy in that first half.
And let's see if he continues that trend the rest of the way. He certainly has the talent and the endurance to do just that.
And we hope you've enjoyed the broadcast so far. We're halfway through the game. Rozier on the wing along with Hayward. The big men on the floor. It's Washington and Plumlee. And it's Ball in at the point guard position. And that's the group for Steve Clifford as we begin the second half. Now here is Edwards. Six on the shot clock. McDaniels. Good on the three-point shot. McDaniels got the lead up to 10 now for the Timberwolves.
Now, Anthony Edwards plays with joy, and you love to see him get his teammates involved. Pretty pass.
Ball kicks to Washington. From beyond the arc and then some. Washington's got himself on the board with three there.
And an eye for an eye. Both teams working to stretch the floor.
Well, that three-point shot just gives you so much room to operate on the offensive end.
Second half just getting started. About a minute played. Russell feeling it out a bit. Here's Towns. Doesn't go for him. And the Hornets now going the other way. They host the 76ers after this game. And that will be the middle game of this three-game homestand. Count that one.
And of the last six baskets, five have come on the interior. This is just smash-mouth physical basketball, guys.
Now here's Edwards. 9 points in the game so far. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Edwards got 11 points.
Taking the contact in the NBA, such a critical skill. Anthony Edwards, the frame and the game.
Hayward outside. Ball finds Rozier. Shot clock at 5. Rudy Gobert with the rebound. Gobert's got his 5th rebound right now in the game.
And for Terry Rozier, all of his efficiency numbers are way up the last couple of years. Here's a guy who's just 37% from the field during his time in Boston.
Now, Washington, after the missed three from Karl Anthony Towns. Rozier with the ball. Very solid contribution from him as he averages over 20 points a game. Count that one, and the Minnesota lead has been cut down now to just 4 points with the basket from Ball. Second half of play, and we're 3 minutes into the third here. And the numbers of Terry Rozier. As you mentioned, they're getting better bit by bit.
Scary Terry's three-point shooting is way up, and that helps big time. With experience, Rozier isn't forcing things offensively, becoming a much better decision maker.
The Timberwolves shooting their fifth attempt at the line in the game. And that one misses. Doris, one thing that stood out about the Timberwolves last season was their fast-paced play.
No doubt, Kevin, and you can trace that directly to the head coaching position in Chris Finch. This is a group that loved to push the basketball up the floor, wanted to catch defenses before they had a chance to dig in the half court. And remember, that is the classic mark of a youthful team, particularly one with the athleticism that Anthony Edwards brings.
Pass to Russell. Here's Towns. Rozier defending. Lets it go from the wing. And Towns the bucket on the assist by Russell. And now it's an 8-point Timberwolves lead.
Well, the more repetition he gets, the more floor awareness you develop. D'Angelo Russell showing a desire to get his teammates involved.
And the Hornets call time here. So it's both teams making substitutions here. In the third quarter with just over 3.5 minutes off the clock. Smith scanning the floor. And the pass to Oubre. Here's Richards. Great pass to set up the lay-in.
Excellent recognition from Kelly Oubre right there. So solid sensing when one of his guys is open.
Timberwolves leading by six. Anderson outside. Pass to Noel. Five on the clock. The Timberwolves need to get a shot off here. Smith with it. Guarded now by Prince. Booknight with the bucket. And now it's just a four-point Timberwolves lead.
And this is what you want from Dennis Smith Jr. He has to find the open man and deliver it on time and on target.
Minnesota's gone 1-2 from beyond the arc since coming out of the break. Here is Forbes. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. Here's Anderson. And the shot goes in. And the Timberwolves lead by 6.
And not quite as aggressive from outside as they were in the first half. Sticking to the high percentage shots, playing smart with the lead.
34 seconds left in the third quarter. Booknight and too long on the shot.
And they're controlling the boards, Kevin. That's plus 5 in that category.
Nice ball movement by Minnesota. Now here's Gobert. Defense is right there. Kicks it out to Prince. Off target from three-point range. And here is Booknight. And he was able to put it up in time, but doesn't fall. And so it's Minnesota with their lead standing at 6 points here at the end of the quarter. They're shooting the ball so well in this one. A great performance from the field. Right back after this break. And let's take this chance now to show you the State Farm assist of the game.
Just true artistry right there. I mean, great decision on where to go with the ball, and how about the perfect delivery?
We call that putting it right in the pocket, and he knew what to do with it once it was there.
And with these teams locked in a very close contest, this fourth quarter promises to be a good one. And a look at the five for the Timberwolves to start the fourth. Sliding in at the wing, it'll be Edwards and McDaniel. Kyle Anderson is out there with Towns, and it's Russell in at the one. Now, here's Ball. From outside, off the mark. Now Edwards. Launches it, and he's good on the three ball.
Yeah, how about the percentage they're shooting from beyond the arc here in the second half?
Rozier against Edwards. Rozier, the pass to Ball. Washington with the screen on Russell. Chalk up two there.
What an electrifying game by LaMelo Ball. Is anyone more exciting than this young guy?
Russell passes to McDaniels. He dishes it to Towns. Outside, Russell. A three from Anderson. The rebound by LaMelo Ball. Hornets trail by 7. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
There is nothing soft about Gordon Hayward at the cup. This guy's superb finishing that one.
And so it's Russell with it. He'll bring it up for Minnesota. They've led by as much as 10. And that's a foul called on Kelly Oubre. That is his first foul of the game. Mason Plumlee's checked in for Oubre. The Timberwolves also with the sub. Reed's checked in. We're about 2 minutes into the fourth quarter in this one. Towns for three. Good, and the assist goes to Russell. Russell's got his third assist on the night.
It's not just the three-point shooting. It's the range three-point shooting. Towns will fire from anywhere.
Hornets trail by eight. We're in the fourth quarter here, just under 2.5 minutes gone. And it's Washington missing. Minnesota's gone 2 of 3 in the fourth quarter from long range. Good shooting so far. Passes it to Reed. Buries it down low. And it's a 10-point Timberwolves lead.
Big miscommunication on defense. He recognizes it and quickly takes advantage.
And that's typical of this guy. He's always reading the situation, reacting quickly, and capitalizing.
They have been board dominant in this game. That's definitely been a factor in crafting this huge lead.
Ball against Russell. Outside, Edwards. Pocket four. Back to Russell. The three. And Rozier pulls it down.
Boy, this guy just can't buy a bucket, and yet they have the advantage.
Ball no good.
And typically he has the touch to finish when he's in tight, but not sure on that possession.
McDaniels kicks to Edwards. Takes the 13-footer. It's rebounded by Charlotte. Plumlee's got his fourth rebound in this one. Throws it up high. Trying to go for an alley-oop, but excellent defense and anticipation there to stop it. Fouled in the act of shooting. Gets the bucket anyway, so a three-point play chance for him.
You can see the assertiveness right now of D'Angelo Russell. He welcomes the contact and powers and plays right through it.
And guys, let's get your take on the scoring breakdown for the Timberwolves.
Their accuracy in this one has just been on another level. I mean, the three ball keeps falling, and the defense just hasn't been able to run them off the line.
I also like how they've played in the painted area. They've made an effort to work on the inside and convert those chances.
And now in the final year of his contract, D'Angelo Russell trying to get back to that all-star level and the promise that got him that last four-year deal.
Now, here's Ball. Count the bucket, and he's got a free throw coming up as well.
Now, you love the tenacity right there of LaMelo Ball. Play through the contact, get the and-one opportunity.
And after a lackluster performance in last year's playoff, Russell has some making up to do.
Yeah, and the efficiency has been a problem. Now, if you're a player whose primary value is at the offensive end, you can't just be a volume scorer.
.141 left in the game. Here's Edwards. He kicks to Gobert. Timberwolves passing it around. Just five on the clock. Gobert with a screen for Edwards. With one on the clock. And slam dunk by Gobert.
And this is what Rudy Gobert's job is. Be a force on the glass.
And the Hornets call time here. They're trailing by 11. There's 1:17 left in the fourth quarter. Ball against Russell. Oubre, no one around him. That falls. Nice feed that time from Ball.
A short corner three works for Kelly Oubre. Nice, smooth shot.
Here is Edwards. 106 left here in the fourth quarter. Clock at six. Shoots from the elbow. They get the rebound. And slam dunk by Gobert.
Well, they knew it would be a hostile environment, and they rose to the challenge.
And sometimes when everyone's rooting against you, it seems to bring the unit closer together. It certainly did tonight.
And so it's Ball who brings the ball up for the Hornets, trailing by 10. Rozier for three. Rudy Gobert with the rebound. There's 31 seconds left in the fourth. Russell against Ball. Now here's Gobert. Down to five on the shot clock. Towns, the pass to Gobert. And slam dunk by Gobert.
Saw the opportunity to put this away and did not turn it down.
Yeah, playing with great energy and great effort. And as a coach, you'd love to see this from your team every single night.
So it's Minnesota winning this one easily. This was a very strong showing for him, Greg. Not necessarily a runaway win, but one they'll feel very good about.
And let's face it, anytime you can go on the road and win in the fashion they did, you have to feel good about it. Really an outstanding effort all the way around.
And now we'll go to David Aldridge, who's standing by with our player of the game. Take it away, David.
Thanks very much. Rudy, your impact on the game defensively, always something to watch. What's your approach at that end?
Just try to win games, you know, and my teammates put a lot of trust in me, being aggressive on the balls and try to be aggressive at the rim. And, you know, when we play as a team like we do tonight, it's tough to beat us.
You were in full Stifle Tower mode tonight, man. Congrats. Back to you.
All right, David. Great job. Thanks so much. And that'll wrap it up, folks. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for tuning in. And now, our New Balance player of the game, Rudy Gobert.